Joining me now is Mike Lindell, CEO of My Pillow and 2020 Trump Advisory Board member. Thank you so much for joining me today.
Thanks for having me on. It's an honor to be on this show. This is great.
So, Mr. Lindell, I wanted to talk a little bit about your mask production. We know that you are producing masks for your community and having those spread also throughout the nation. Please tell me a little bit more about that. How many masks are you guys making?
I don't know how many, but we're up to be with what I did when I first got involved. We made some prototypes. I first made it safe for my employees. I said, we're going to go into making masks. They need us out there. So we made it very safe. And I want to say this, like my employees, they had to feel comfortable right away. So we had, they come in, every one of them gets put some mask on, wash their hands, sanitize. We have everything 8 feet apart. I let them take breaks whenever they want so that they can go by themselves. So it's very safe. And I sanitized my whole, 200,000 square feet of factory. So, but that first and foremost, and then we started training how to make them. We've gotten better and better. It's very labor intensive. In 8 hours, you can make about 120 masks for one person. So, but I reached out to other people I deal with, like my fabric for my toppers and stuff. They all got involved. I think we're up to a little over 50,000 a day now. And it's been so amazing. The first ones, we went out to hospitals and stuff, and now it seems like they've kind of caught up maybe with their distributors. And then now it's things like first responders, nursing homes, all these other places have reached out. And now we're even getting businesses to start reach out if they're opening back up, because obviously every business should be very safe when you reopen, because you're the one that's going to get the business.
Mr. Lindell, I understand that you started your company, MyPillow, as early as 2004, meaning that your company would have been active during the 2008 economic downturn that many Americans faced. So through that, what kind of comparison would you draw between then and now as far as the economy? And what kind of advice would you offer small business owners in how to survive this stressful time?
Well, you know, both things were kind of an anomaly, especially this one. But in 2008, I was still heavy into my addiction. I was a crack cocaine addict. And I was just doing the trenches then, which is the home shows and fairs going around the country and selling at home show and fairs. So when you were affected because the economy is so bad, people are, you know, tighter on money. This one's different. With this one, my advice is, I want everybody to look at right before this pandemic, where we were as a nation, what this administration had put us in such a great position, biggest consumer confidence, lowest unemployment. I mean, at least we're sitting here with so much hope because when that happened beforehand. But I want to say, keep the faith, because when we come out of this, and I want the businesses that come out and practice safe practices, you can see right now by the essential businesses that are open. I go to the gas station that I know is practicing safe practices. I go in the grocery store that's practicing safe practices. So my advice to a small business out there, make sure when you come out, you're doing everything to make not only your employees feel safe, but customers feel safe. And that's going to spring you ahead of everybody else. And I just know that we're going to get back to a place very fast and even go beyond that, because you've got to realize, yes, it's right now, it's hard to see what's going to be the future because our footprint will be different. But I think it's going to be so accelerated. People are going to, all this relief coming from the government, you're going to have more people that have money, but you're also, you know, we're going to be protected. Our president's going to protect us. And I just say, keep the faith. And when you come out of this, you know, I think the economy is just going to go straight up. I really believe that, but you can get ahead of the curve by making your business the best business coming out of it.
Due to the current circumstances, rehab centers aren't operating the same way that they used to just a couple months ago. So I wonder, as someone who has battled with addiction throughout their lifetime, Mike, what kind of advice would you offer people who need that rehabilitation service and can't get it right now?
Well, you know, right before this pandemic, I was coming out. It was called the Lindell Recovery Network, which I still launch when this is done. And it's going to be the most amazing platform for help ever. And I've been there. I know what, they're one of the things in my book. I had a guy come to me in 2008, and he came to me, and he was my equal. Both of us had started cocaine at the same time. We had switched to crack at the same time. And I had heard he had made it through 4 years earlier, that he had quit. And he showed up out of nowhere, and I said, Dick, what are you doing here? And he said, the Lord led me here. But I said, well, I had questions for him, like, is it boring? He said, no, man, it ain't boring. I drilled him with all these questions because too many times in the treatment world, you go to these secular treatment or whatever, and they don't go to the issues. They have someone that's never maybe been an addict. He's went to school for 4 years to be a counselor. I want to hear from an addict that's made it through, and I want to hear from that person that's maybe done my same drug, maybe my same age. So my advice right now in this time, there's advice for both people out there. One's the addict that's sitting at home. Now's your time to reach out to friends of yours. We all know people that have died and stuff. It's horrific, the things going on with addiction right now. But you know, if you're 20, let's say, I'll give you an example. You're a 22-year-old heroin addict, and you're sitting there and you're going, but you also know friends of yours that have made it through. Now's the time to reach out to them. Them are your hope matches. You reach out to them and say, how did you do it? And you confide in them and ask them questions, and they go and find out how they're feeling now, how things are working out. And that's going to give you so much hope. And these are your hope matches. My story, when you see my book, that gives this big hope and say, you know, but the closer you get to a match for your own age. Now, on the other hand, if you've made it through and you're at home, this is the time for you to reach out to your friends that are still caught mired in addiction. Reach out. We can make this the biggest AA meeting in history with Jesus as our higher power. And this is where I believe that this is going to be part of the great revival. I mean, to bring people out of addiction because they're looking for hope and they are feeling hopeless right now. And right now, reach out. There's millions of people that made it through too, like I have. And this is where we can make this, you know, both. And that gives the addict hope. And then it gives you this other person here, gives them something to do to help the addict. So that's my advice. I think we're all in this together. It's amazing. It's going to be amazing times to get this country rid of addiction once and for all. And by the way, I want to say this. Addiction is not just somebody in the streets. I was a very functioning addict. Addiction affects every person, no matter how many forks you eat with. Right now it's gotten so widespread, you know, and I don't care what kind, if it's drugs, alcohol, porn, sex, overeating, gambling, whatever it is, they're all masks for pain, and they're all, you know, and that's what it is. And there's better lives. There's a better way. And people that have made it through need to show those people that.
Mike, you have a new book coming out. Please tell us a little bit more about that. Where can people go and get it?
It's called What Are the Odds? From Crack Addict to CEO. But it took me 7 years to write. And this goes back. We all have things in our life that say one in a million. Wow, that's a one in a million. That's a one in a billion. Or maybe we put something off to chance and go, that's impossible. Well, when do you add them together and you consider it a miracle? And in this book, in my book, it's faith. It's entrepreneurship, never give up, the American dream. It's addiction. I mean, there's all these things wrapped into one. One of the things you're going to see when you read the book, the last thing in history, I come from a divorced family, and divorces weren't common when I was 7 years old. And that manifested. I was very shy in this new school I was put in. I didn't fit in. I felt I was different. I would do stuff to show off. I had 14 near-death experiences. All these things are in there. But then to end up my calling being not to be shy and talking in public, I'm going, you know, one of the scenes in the book there, I did my first infomercial and they're going, and I wanted to do it my way with the real audience and stuff. And this big producer, we were doing our reads and he texts the other guy, said, this is the worst guy I've ever seen. He'll never make it on TV. But there's the book is a hope, and it's going to bring hope at this perfect time in history. I launched it. I pre-printed, by the way, 3 million copies. I self-published, bought my own paper. I didn't want any middlemen. I wanted to bring it right to the public because I'm taking that money. I'm using that money to help launch the Lindell Recovery Network because I don't reach out to self, you know, I want to be self-funding and help so many people in this country out of addiction. But this, it's amazing. You can get it at mypillow.com right now on my website. And we're also putting in I think we're giving a $25 gift certificate free too with the book. So I just wanted to get it out there, and it's exploded in a big way because of the timing, you know, to give people hope that in our country, there's no way this could be possible other than the United States, where Mike, I'm going from a crack addict to where I'm in now. You know, my friends, one time I'm sitting, the president invited me to the White House for a Made in America thing summit, and I'm sitting next to the president. And I'm going, it's all surreal for me. And they go, my friends go, what's that ex-crack addict doing on the TV sitting next to the president? There, Jesus has to be real because this is impossible.
Mike, you have a pretty incredible story, and I appreciate you taking time out of your day to share that with our audience. Thank you so much. Again, Mike Lindell, CEO of MyPillow and Trump 2020 Advisory Board member.
Well, thanks for having me. And everybody, keep the faith. We're going to get through this, and it's going to be safer and the strongest economy ever. It's going to be amazing. And we're all in this together. I think this is going to be a great uniter of the country, too, to and just if you're a small business, keep the faith. It's going to be amazing.